Swarupa is one and the same, whether a terrorist or a saint. Chaitanya that activates a terrorist is the same Chaitanya that operates well in a saint. We look at the embodiment, but this person is within the center where in the Swarupa, which is his own Swarupa. Just as, look here, you see all the electrical gadgets with different functions. But if you are within the center of electricity, irrespective of the gadget, what is that only? One electrical energy. So like this is within the center. In that case, one doubt only. What is the doubt? In Gautama Dharma Sutra, it is said, in a yaga, etc., wherein great Brahmins are assembled, Brahmins having different qualifications, and it is that they have to be honored. Yadhyaga means even beside the Ritviks, all the spectators who are Brahmins, etc., they have to be honored because it's the honor of the Vedas. But while honoring them, there is gradation. You can't treat everyone equal. Depending on higher and higher qualification, higher honor has to be given. If Yajamana does what? Treats all of them at the same rate, he says, food in his house is what? Abhaksha. Brahmin should not eat. Great sin. Now, see, Gautama Dharma Sutra says you can't treat everyone alike, and this Jnani what? Treats everyone alike. How is it? Vision is different. That this sutra is told in Karma Kanda, that is, a karma sacrifice is done, identification of the body is there. But here is the context of Atma Jnana, wherein body doesn't come into picture at all. All that is Atma Swarupa, which is above the characteristic features of the body. Therefore, his vision is correct, that Gautama Dharma Sutra is not applicable here. Therefore, it says what? In each and every embodiment with different characteristic features, this Jnani is able to directly cognize, directly experience one Chaitanya Tattva free from all embodiment. Therefore, I say, Samam Brahma. For him, Brahma is what? One and the same in all the embodiment. So, and therefore, where is he abiding? Brahmani eva desita. Up to here, Bhashya we have seen. Ataha, Samam Brahma. Ekamcha yasma brahmani eva desita. You should be able to locate, okay? Because books are different. I can't give you this page, this line, etc. I can't tell you. You should. Easy. How? Earlier class you have to make a. Earlier class you have to make a note, then that's all. If you have not come in the earlier class, you can somebody who can find out what is. Generally, you know, the style is, before proceeding, you read two, three lines of the Bhashya, but this is Bombay. time is so short. But one thing, you are supposed to read that portion and come here. I expect you, because you will revise it. You may not know much Sanskrit, but you have heard about it, teaching is there. Some idea will be there, do it, okay? So that my job will be easy. I did not repeat every time. I can save that much. You won't say only once a week. And Bhashya portion is so voluminous. Voluminous. So that you can just how many? 7-8 lines it will be. Just 7-8 lines, just go through it. Or go through your notes. At least make use of. I know in this class there are people whose head is always like this. I ask, can I get one more book? Difficult to search. Oh, what is the use of these notes? If you don't go through them, what, even this, what I said, will be there in the notes. So that is that. So at least go through your means, you should be little means aware of what was being taught. It becomes easier for you. You can collect in leather and order every time. Clean slate. Clean slate. But that's not okay. So up to here is it means in and through all these embodiments. Gavi, Hastini, Shudhi, Shapake. So one darshana, vision of our Sama Brahma. Sama Brahma means one non-dual Brahma free from all the embodiment. Therefore, see, dosha, what dosha defect? What defect told in the Gautama Dharma Sutra doesn't touch them at all?
Tasman. Na dosha gandha matram api tan sprushati dehadi sanghatatma darshanabhimana bhavat.
Tasmat. Tasmat means because their vision is centered in one and the same non-changing Chaitanya Tattva Brahma, free from all embodiment, free from entire features of the Jagat. So tasma tan. Tan means samyak darshinaha pandita. Panditas, see this word pandita, Buddha Vedas will say pandita means what? Scholar. Maharashtra cook also is called pandita. Like here, Gujarat. Maharaj means a saint is called Maharaj. Cook also is called. It happened. Immediately after our course, for 1 year, I was at Nagpur. I used to take bhiksha at somebody's house. And you know, one pandit used to come and make rotis. One day it happened. I went to some other house. There also they were talking of pandit only. And they may be just like in a contract to hear some rotis, their rotis, they must be doing it. After a few months, I happened to go to 15 kilometers away and I stayed there. They are also universal pandit. This pandit is there. I asked him, what is his name? No. We call the cook as pandit. Cook as pandit. So like the cook also is Maharaj. So not that way here. So pandita, see actually panda means brahmanya. You know praya, gaya, etc. Panda. They are supposed to be dhyanis. So panda. How the words get corrupted, how they get worded. So that Prabhu tam, those people. Who are those people? Samyak darshinaha pandita. The panditas, dhyanis, who have got the vision of one and the same Brahma in and through all the embodiment. Tasmat, because their vision is centered in Brahma Swarupa. Dosha gandha matram api na sprishati. Dosha gandha matram api. Even a wee bit of defects of, that is what, treating all equally, etc., and inserting somebody. You did not insert, but other get inserted. Because if you treat the highly qualified and the low person same, it insert to the other person, highly qualified person. So there is a ganda dosha ganda matramapi na sprishati. So why? Dehadi sanghatatma darshanabhimana manasya abhava. Because in them, this is not there. I notion in the embodiment or identification with the embodiment is not there. Their mind is well absorbed in the Chaitanya Swarupa. They are not aware of the body, leave alone the features of the body. So, abhava. Whereas, that Gautama Dharma Sutra is applicable to those who are identified with the embodiment and take to different karmas, yajna, yagas. So it clarifies. Dehadis, right?
Dehadi sanghatatma darshanabhi manavad vishayam. तो तत्सूत्रम समासमाभ्याम विषमसमे पूजातः इति पूजा विषयत्व विशेषणात्.
तत्सूत्रम, तत्सूत्रम मीन्स व्हाट? गौतम Dharma Sutra. So for whom it is, it pertains to what topic? Dehadi Sanghatatma Darshana Abhimana Vad Vishaya. The topic's topic is the one who is endowed with the identification with the Deha Adi. Adi for Indriya, Mana, Buddhi, Prana. Embodiment, entire embodiment. So, that sutra is applicable to those who are identified with the embodiment. That's what is said, namely, sama asama abhyam vishama same pujataha, the yajamanaha abhojanyaha bhavati. It is to be completed that way. Yeah, we have already told in the beginning, the sutra was told in the beginning of this bhashya. यजमानः अभोज्यानः भवति. समासमाभ्यः सम having same qualification, असम having varying qualification for them, विषमसमे पूजातः is same qualification is there, honor must be same. If Vishama is there, varying is there, depending on the degree of qualification, you have to give her honor also, should say. Not that any way it is given. Either all are rated samely or wrongly, more or less is given. The food in the Yajamana, in the house of this Yajamana, is abhojya. Abhojya, abhojya means is unworthy of partaking for Brahmanas. If Brahmana takes that, he will incur the sin. So therefore, this sutra is meant for whom? Those who are identified with the embodiment and taking to karmas. But our context is different. Our context is different. Iti puja vishayatva visheshana. Puja here is not worship, honor, honoring. Because context is of honoring the Brahmanas with different qualification. Therefore, now tell me, scholasticity and the study and the qualification belongs to whom? Tell me, in this individual, to which exact aspect it belongs? Body? Mind into that. Knowledge in the Buddhi. It will be. Upadhi only, not Atma Sarupa. So there, puja vishayatva visheshana. Same thing, different types of scholars are told now.
Drishyatehi, Brahmavid, Sharangavid, Chaturvedavid, इति पूजा दानादौ गुण विशेष संबंधः कारणम्
दृश्यते हि. सच डिफरेंसेस आर फॉर्म. व्हाट आर दो? ब्रह्मविद. दिस पर्सन इज हु? ब्रह्मविद. हु इज ब्रह्मविद? ब्रह्मज्ञानी. यस. But at times, Brahmavid can be Vedavid. Veda also is called Brahma. But generally, Brahmavid is who? Brahma Jnani. Brahmavid Varishtaha, word used in the Mundaka Upanishad, which speaks of the seven stages of jnanam, jnana. So that here, it can be jnani or one who knows Vedas. It has to be taken as one who knows Vedas because immediately Sharangavit comes there. The one who has studied six Vedangas, Nyaya, Kalpa, Vyakarana, Jyotisha, and all the Chandas, all this is because to ascertain the meaning of this Veda, you should know grammar, prosody. Again, Karmakanda means you should be able to read the sky astronomy. What time there were no cell phone alarms, don't cell phone alarms were not there. You have to find out based on the sky. Oh, see, even when I was a child, etc., you see, belly has come. Farmers, early morning, they used to get up and go to the forest to cut the wood. They had no timepiece and all that. What is the belly? You know, belly means, literally means silver, Kannada silver. But here, belly means Shukra. Shukra. Shukra has risen his heart. It's around 4 o'clock or so. That was the time for them to get up and go like that. So, you see, all this is necessary for Karmakanda and otherwise, Mimamsa, all this is necessary. Shadangavit, one who is scholar in all the six auxiliaries, Anga here is auxiliaries of the Veda. Chaturvedavit, who knows four Vedas. You know, have you seen it? Dvivedi, Trivedi, Chaturvedi. You know that, excellent. Max Muller was translating many of these Vedic portions. And it was a fashion those days, our Indian youngsters who go there for study to beat Max Muller. IAS, not ICS, both is ICS. ICS students, etc. This is a great honor for them. Who have been to Max Muller. One youngster who was doing ICS, Chaturvedi, he went to meet and sent the car. Max also, Chaturvedi. He was so happy. See, he came all along out to the gate to receive him. So please come, please come. See, the name itself involved so much. Please come here. Baki kisi ko chai pani nahi milta na, isko chai pani. Chai pani diya isko. I'm very glad that I could meet you, etc. See, I had some doubt about this particular portion of Vedas was not making sense. I'm sure you'll be able to. No, this person, he wanted to pose it today. What are they doing? What Vedas? All nonsense. He showed him the way out. Showed him the way out. So name may be Chaturvedi. How many Vedas are there? He may not know. I had a neighbor just opposite Chaturvedi. I don't know if he knows Vedas or Chaturvedi. No, Chaturvedi. One has studied all the four Vedas, capable of becoming a Brahma. Brahma means chief officiating priest. So, Chaturvedavit, one who knows four Vedas. Iti puja dana dau, in honoring or giving something in charity like this. It is fixed by Vedas. So many calls to such a person, so many calls in, so much of gold to such person, it must be fixed in the Veda. So, guna vishesha sambandha karana. Karana, the means of judging how to honor, how much to give in dana, is that qualification, guna vishesha sambandha. Their features. Now, what about the gunas of Brahma? Is it this Brahma? This is Bharatiya Brahma. That is Pakistani Brahma. Other one is Bangladesh Brahma. That one is China Brahma. Did you think? Brahma has no Vishesha. These rules do not apply. Continue.
Brahma tu sarva guna dosha sambandha varjitam.
Sarva guna dosha sambandha varjitam.
Iti ataha.
Iti ataha.
Brahmani te sitaha.
Brahmani te sitaha.
Iti yuktam.
Iti yuktam.
Tu, in contrast to this, the who are identified the embodiment and taking to puja, etc. Brahma, sarva guna dosha sambandha varjitam. Varjitam, free from, devoid of, sarva guna dosha sambandha. Sambandha, connection to all merits and demerits. In the plus points and points. See, look, you should be very careful. Your eye should be centered on the words of the Bhasha. I am giving meaning of each and every word. But don't expect me what karanam means cause, sambandha means. You should be able to connect them. Again, many times sentences will be incomplete in the Bhasha itself. Bhasha sentences are not complete because there, this word, a phrase is explaining. At places, sentences are complete. Bhasha style is what? Take each and every word of the Mula, Shloka or Mantra, and then explain. At times, in general, summarizing, etc., may be there. Two, whereas Brahma is sarva guna dosha sambandha varjitam. I hope this much you can know. Sarva guna dosha sambandha varjitam. You don't need knowledge of Sanskrit. Varjitam, devoid of, free from all sambandha connection with the guna, virtues, and dosha defect. Iti ataha, because of iti, because of this reason, ataha, therefore, te means samadarshinaha panditaha. The jnana is who see the one and the same Brahma in and through varieties of embodiment. So, Brahmani te sitaha, their vision is centered where? In Brahma, iti yuktam, this statement of Lord Krishna is proper. Whereas the statement of Gautama Dharma Sutra refers to karma.
Karmi Vishayam Cha Samasamabhyam Ityadi.
Samasamabhyam Ityadi.
Whereas Samasamabhyam Ityadi. Samasamabhyam is the phrase referring to Gautama Dharma Sutra. It is the Gautama Dharma Sutra. Ityadi means this sutra is what? Karmi Vishayam. The topic is what? Karma, and the person who does the karma. Whereas, what is the topic here?
Idam tu Sarva Karma Sanyasa Vishayam.
Sarva Karma Sanyasa Vishayam.
Prastuta. Sarva Karmani Manasa.
Sarva Karmani Manasa.
Iti Arabhya. Adhyayas Parisamabdehe.
Idam to, this topic where being discussed in Bhagavad Gita, 5th chapter, from stanza 13, pertains to what? Sarva Karma Sanyasa Vishaya. It is related to sannyasa, giving up of all karma. How was it introduced by Lord Krishna in stanza 13 of this chapter? Prastutam. So it was presented. How? Sarva karmani manasa sannyasa sannyasya aste sukham vashi navadvare puredehi naiva kurvanna kare. Stanza 13 of this chapter. So this jnani remains, dwells in this embodiment, having given up all karmas. How? Mentally. What you mean by giving up mentally? Doership. I do, this notion is not there. See, all activities are done at what level? You have come to this class. Yes or no?
Yes.
Now tell me what all process took place after you get the water. You got it. Oh, suddenly only. Gita Bhashya. Then? Should I go today? Or not? I think so many work is there. Let me skip today.
No.
Bhashya is such that if you miss a class, it is like mathematics. You miss a lot. Let me go. What happened? Manasa sankalpa. To go on. Vidya nishchitya. No, let me go. Then you don't land in the class. What you have to do? Either walk, drive, or take any transport, etc. Then manasa sankalpa. Vidya nishchitya. Karanaihi karma karo. First, we think to do or not to do. If you do, you have decided to do. Buddhi has decided. Then, karanaihi, karmendriya, jnanendriya, all that you have to press into function to execute what you have decided. Is it not? So that we say, here, maybe, even he may be eating, but he has no concept that I am eating. Unless he is aware of the body. So he is so absorbed. So that's why I see there are different stages of this knowledge. In some stage, once he is out of samadhi, he is aware of the body, like normal person, he will eat, etc. But not like a normal person. Otherwise, suppose he is in the intense state, then somebody else has to take care of him. Have you seen this? Children, very small children, sometimes they sleep. Not Bombay children. Bombay children, I think, up to midnight, they are also light. Older days, you have to see the towns, etc., and the villages. 7 o'clock means all dark, some lantern, etc., used to be there. And then, the mother never used to give that dinner early because you sleep. You, the moment you eat the food, you sleep. Study. They have to study. Cluster, not a lantern, brothers, sisters, etc., etc. 9:30 will be the dinner. Till then you are supposed to go on. Now, children, they sleep. The mother wakes up. This fellow is on. Still half sleeping. So Rodi, he comes, eats. Mummy, yesterday you didn't give me dinner. Why? He wasn't aware of it. He gulped what was put, was gulped, but he was not totally aware. So like that, the jnani may not be totally aware. Somebody has to do that. So let us see. At least by efforts of others, he comes to the awareness of the body and the jagat. Highest pain out of question. I told you now, the instance of the guru of present Shankaracharya Sringeri Math, Abhinava Vidyatirtha, present one is Bharatirtha, and he has taken a disciple, Vidura Shekhara. But Bharatirtha's guru, Abhinava Vidyatirtha, at the age of 18, to go in the sabha. And 1 or 2 days or so continuously, he was not able to take the bath and do his anushtanga. So the food is just for soup and all that is different. And he was totally immersed. Next day morning, Guru came. Asked attendant to go up, go at the throat. This person was lost in samadhi. He sat in front of him and started chanting Om, Om, Guru, Chandrasekhar Bharati, himself a Jivan Mukta, not ordinary person. Thank you. After 2 hours, Abhinavidya Kirta heard some sound, Omkara, and he could detect it in whose voice? Guru's voice. He opened his eyes. Guru is sitting. Guru said, get up, take bath, do your Anushthana and see me. He went. He got up. Did Anushthana took bath? Did Anushthana mean they have to do certain of these things? Oh, and he went. Said, sit down. Yesterday night, I have received a divine communication that you should not practice samadhi. If you practice samadhi, you will be landing in a such a state, so nobody will be able to bring you out of that. This is the verge of sixth state into seventh state. As for the Shastra, the verge of sixth state into, notice that. But you have to, you are supposed to do a lot of work. Number one, you have to do my Guru's work, because Chandrasekhar Bharati retired earlier and all the Vishthama was given to the disciple. Number two, you have to do the work of the Math. You are a pontiff. Number three, you have to serve the society. Since then, only one hour is to. You can't, it's not a pocket rule thing at all. So, that is that. And, you know, say this treachery of it was, this was at age of 18. At the age of 23, he had to study Tarka and Bhashyas. Think of it. One who is immersed in the Paramananda, he had the Bhashya and the Tarka. But he had to do it for the welfare of the people. The post that he is donning. So therefore says, so here is a person who, when aware of the body, he may do, but I notion is not there. Sarva karmani masa, he remains in the body. Iti arabhya. So this topic was introduced by in stanza 13. How far it continues? Adhyaya parisamapti. Be careful about this thing. It is not adhyaya parisamapti. Two words. A plus adhyaya parisamapti. A plus adhyaya parisamapti. A means what? Paryantam. Or beginning also. Beginning from. Or here it is. Paryantam. Up to the end of this chapter. Which chapter? Chapter 5. So what Krishna is describing is the disposition of a jnani, one who has given up all karmas by mind. Maybe he is continuing in the embodiment as per the prarabdha. Next verse.
Yasmat. Nirdosham samam brahma atma. Tasmat.
This is what is called as prastavana. Prastavana means introduction. Introduction to what? Next verse. Bhashyakara is introducing the next verse. Yasmat nirguna. Question comes like this. How do you say jnani's vision, mind, is centered in samam brahma? Does he not have harsha vishala? Has he got a body or not? Then, so long as the body is there, joys and sorrows are there or not? Something. At least something. I'm sitting for meditation and his neighbor's TV is blaring. Neighbor will say, if you want to meet Mayavi here, go to the phone. Go to the forest. Go to the forest. So, then he will get annoyed, is it not? Or something which is desired by him take place, is he not going to be happy? So what do you say? Yes, no. Harsha Vishada. When Harsha. See, so long as you are in the body, occasions for harsha, vishada are there or not? Occasions to be happy, occasions to be sorrowful are bound to be there. How do you say sama brahma? So, Tamar says, his vision is not in the harsha vishada of embodiment. He is centered where? In the brahma sabha. Joys and sorrows are for who? You expect something, you get, you are happy. You have to avoid something you could not avoid. You have so many varieties, many causes may be there for joys and sorrows. He has nothing to expect, he has nothing to get rid of. He is centered where? In the swarupa. There is no occasion for him to have harsha vishada on account of body and bodily needs. So therefore yasma nirdosham samam brahma. Brahma is free from defects, one and the same paramananda swarupa. Again same is what? Atma. And that brahma is his swarupa. Atma I. Tasma. Therefore Lord Krishna says, continue the verse.
Na prahrishye priyam prapya, no dvije prapya cha priyam,
no dvije prapya cha priyam,
sthira buddhira sammoodaha,
sthira buddhira sammoodaha,
brahmavid brahmani sthitaha,
brahmavid brahmani sthitaha.
Take second line, add yaha. Yaha sthira buddhi asambhura brahmavit brahmani sthitaha and saha priyam prapya na pravrishe. Apriyam cha prapya na udvijet. In short, in case of a jnani, harsha shoka are not there. He is not aware. At times, maybe because the prarabdha is conscious about. For example, see, Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, he had the throat cancer. Throat cancer. But when he was immersed in Swarupa, he was not aware of it. But he was, when conscious of the body, he used to complain, Mother, I am not able to eat. Mother means Kali Devi, Kali Mata. I am not able to eat. He had that communication with the mother. The mother said, why you want to eat with this mouth? You are eating with all the mouths. What does it mean? You are Sarvatma, Atma abiding in all. This embodiment has got cancer, no doubt. But what about other embodiment? So the Ramana verse, he had the cancer of the arm. He told, let it be there, don't bother about it. No. We can do surgery and this. He told his best man, okay, he did it. They did it. Again it flared up. Again they did it. I think 2-3 times they did it. And finally said, nothing can be done. They said, I told you in the beginning. And now you are telling me nothing can be done. I didn't tell you to do. The body has got its own. So, body is going, it is prarabdha. It has nothing to do with the Atma Jnana, Brahma Jnana. You know, see, in the life of Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, there is an incident. See, he was going for a walk or somewhere. He found so many people gathered together. He was a medicine. And they were making a fun of a person. What is that? A person looking like a madcap, sitting on a dog, with the rotis in the hand, he was eating and also giving to the God. And these people were making fun of him. After some time, that person said, Vishnu parisito Vishnu, Vishnu khadayati Vishnavi, katham asasire Vishnu, sarvam Vishnumayam jagat. Ramakrishna Paramahansa understood his jnani, others said some other madness is coming. Vishnu parisito sito Vishnu. Vishnu is sitting on Vishnu. On which Vishnu? Dog. Dog is Vishnu. Me is Vishnu. I'm sitting there. Vishnu khadayati Vishnave. This Vishnu is feeding the dog Vishnu. Are Vishnu, why are you laughing? See, it needs little viveka and maturity even to understand the vision. To get is different thing. To understand the vision of a, it is not pocket, to at least have this value. There is such a thing, our Swarupa is life. It is worth investigating. You may fail. Are you able to walk today? You have no fracture, nothing. Yes. Ask your mother how she had to struggle to make you walk. How many times you are falling down? Failures are not good. That doesn't mean you didn't give up walking. A person who puts for the effort may make 100 mistakes, but who doesn't put for the effort will make thousands of failures are bad, but at least have that I must, and more so because, you know, this knowledge can be gained only in human embodiment. Exception is Brahma Loka. Forget about Brahma Loka. It is not easy to get it. And human embodiment is very, very, very difficult to get. Very difficult. Jantu Aam Dara Janma Durlabha. And we have no value for human embodiment. Hi. Hi. Whatever you have, you don't have much value for it. But it is not. No. We are Hindus. Punarjanma. Punarjanma is there. But who knows what is the next embodiment? You may be a cock or a bull or a crow or a mouse. Or a snake, because all the time now you hiss. Or a dog, because you bark. Who knows? Or it may be, see, you took to Vedanta, you got a lot of punya, straight away where? Heaven. Aye, padanti. All heavenly treatment. You will be there for a very long time. And when you descend down, the punya is there. Kali Yuga has advanced, the moment to take the name of Bhagavad Gita or Upanishad, rotten eggs will come. Walk it all together. So, don't miss the opportunity of having got the human embodiment. Then Maratha was saying that, Hatsa sasa sodla kasa. A rabbit, you had caught it. How did you leave it? Once, can you get it back? So you have got it now. Don't be there. No, I am not able to pray. He is waiting for such prayer. Who? Ishwara. He is waiting for the prayer. Not other thing. Give me this, give me that. No. You may have to pray. Bhagavan, give me jnana and vairagya. Be honest about it. Huh? Or not this service. So honest. You will see to it. He never fails. We fail. He never fails. There is no room for despair. We can always pray. So this Yaha, the one who is Sthirabuddhi. Buddhi here is jnana. See, buddhi means intellect. Intellect in the sense, the means of gaining knowledge. Or actual jnana also is called buddhi. You have to see the content. Sthirabuddhi. One is buddhi with jnana. Vijnana, not in jnana. Atma jnana is what? Sthira. Sthira means free from doubt, steadfast. Asampura, the knowledge is so steady, steadfast, no, that is that he has no doubts, free from doubt. Knowledge having such a clarity that no doubts whatsoever. Again, he is what? Brahmavid. One who has got direct experience of Brahma, totally free from ajnana, embodiment and prapancha. Brahmani sthitah, absorbed in the Brahma swarupa. Saha, the second line must be fulfilled. Then only the first line will be applicable. Means a person with atma jnani, brahma jnani, who has, what is that? No doubts about this. Again, no asambuddha. Asambuddha means no errors. Sthirabuddhi, no doubts. Asambuddha is no errors. What errors? Errors of mistaking the body as I. Presently what we do, we take the body as I. But this person never commits the mistake of taking the body as I. Why? Because he is Brahmavid, Brahma Jnani. Not simply Brahma Jnani, Brahmanishita, mind absorbed in the Brahma Swarupa. Saha. Priyam Prapya Na Prarushi. Priyam Prapya. From the hitherto evaluation, something desirable. Now we have no such. What value structure? This is Priya, that is a Priya, no. But till now, what you used to consider as desirable, Priyam Prapya, Na Prarushe, doesn't rejoice, doesn't exult. To understand this, we have to compare ourselves. When something desired thing takes place, ha ha. You rejoice, is it? Again, apriyam cha prapya na udvide. If something undesirable takes place, he doesn't get subjected to sorrow. He doesn't say. Generally, what happens? Ayo. Ayo means what? This should not have happened. So this ups and downs in our lives are there because of desired and undesired things. This person is what? Brahmani sthita, is absorbed in the swarupa. These things doesn't matter anything to him because he is so absorbed in swarupa, he is not aware of the body. Even body lineage at higher level. At higher level, you are not aware. Fifth and sixth stage, you are not aware of the body lineage. Others have to take care of it. That is what happened. You know, Totapuri is a yogi from Puri, Puri Jagannath. From ashram there. So he was always on the move. 3 days, not more than 3 days, this is said about him. He landed in Dakshineshwar. He saw him, home, Ramakrishna, and he could make out. He is at the peak of Saguna Brahma Upasana, short of Nirguna Brahma Jnana. He is a very ready sadhak. So he initiated him in the meditation on Nirguna. Said, no, I can't do it. Mother is coming. Who is mother? Kali. Mother is coming.
Get it away.
And he fought something here actually. The final curtainment. See, mother, Kali or Ishwara, which are? Srishti. So that's it. It is necessary for Upasana. But in the ultimate Nirguna Brahmajnana, that Ishwara also has to. And he found, he is totally absorbed. He is not coming back. Then he understood. This body must have a special purpose to serve the humanity. Because I said, what took me 40 years of sadhana, this person has accomplished just like that. So that was he who took care of the body, and he was in that state for 40 days. Generally, when such samadhi is there, at the seventh stage, by the day of 20-21, the body falls off. He was for 40 days. So he understood there is something special about this body. He used to thrust the little morsels of food, etc., by beating, making sound, etc., to make him aware, to bring to the consciousness of the body, etc. So, he is not just like that, he is at the, but at the very high level of the stages of absorption, the jnana nishtha. But generally, so he is not, even if he is aware of the jagat and the body, harsha vishada is not. See, one is very full and complete. Let us say, multi-billionaire, 1,000 rupees will make the difference. Whether you give or take, somebody offers a birthday gift, 1,000 rupees. You will take it because the expression of love. But does it make a difference? Or he gives 10,000, does it make a difference? And that is so Ananda Sarupa, these incense of Harsha Vishada matter nothing to him. Apriyam na udvide.
न प्ररुष्येत न हर्षं कुर्यात् प्रियं इष्टं प्राप्य लब्ध्वा न उद्विजेत् प्राप्य एव च अप्रियं अनिष्टं लब्ध्वा
न प्ररुष्येत. See, literally it is the potential gift. Such a person should not exult, should not rejoice greatly. It is not potential note, it should be such a person does not exult, doesn't rejoice greatly as. Why it is in nature? Na harsham kurya means he doesn't exult. Meaning of pravrishti is na pravrishti is given as na harsham kurya. It doesn't exert. It doesn't exert. When priyam ishtam prapya. Prapya means labdhva. See, style. Priyam. What is priyam? Meaning is given ishtam, desire. Prapya. What is meaning of prapya? Labdhva. I mean what? And if you don't know labdhva, see dictionary. Okay. So having got that desirable, he is what? He is not, he doesn't exert. Again, non vijay prapya eva cha apriyam anishtam labdho. Non vijay, he doesn't get agitated, he doesn't grieve, or doesn't get afflicted, or doesn't become sorrowful. When apriyam anishtam cha prapya eva. I have got something which is apriya. Apriya means anishta. Anishta means undesirable. Prapya meaning again given what? Labdhva. Labdhva having what? Now to understand this, you have to draw a contrast. Who is this person? Jnana. He has no identification with the body. Harsha Vishada, don't make this. Now see the case of an Ajnani who is identified with the embodiment. Harsha comes, Mercury goes up. Vishada comes, goes down. So that contrast is not used.
Hari Om.